open lines, hot sun and clear blue skies. The waves were crashing by, and when she passed me by and gave a wink and smile, and I was on cloud nine, love. The way you move your hips and lick your lips, the way you dip, you got me up so high.
First DIY I'll be showing you is a mason jar light. What you're going to need is a mason jar, IKEA light kit, your favorite light bulb, a marker, spray paint, which is optional, pliers, and hammer and nail. The first thing you're going to do is screw off this piece on your IKEA light kit. You're going to use this piece to trace the circumference on the top of your mason jar. Once you've completed that, you're going to take your hammer and nail and hammer in small holes around the line that you've just traced. I didn't have a hammer or nail, so I improvised and used a cooking mallet and a screw. Once you've done that, you're going to screw off the top of the mason jar, and you will take the socket with the holes in it that you have just created. You're then going to take the pliers and carefully bend and twist around to break off the centerpiece. Be sure to insert a hole in the center like I did. It makes it easier to get around and cut it off. Now, this next part is optional, but I chose to spray paint my top pieces as well as the head of the IKEA light kit. Once you've done this, you then can let it dry. After it's dry, you're then going to take the outer rim of the mason jar and slide it through your IKEA light kit. Then, you'll wedge the socket that you've cut open onto the IKEA light kit. Next, you can screw on your light bulb. After that, place the light inside the mason jar. Screw it in tight, and there you have it, your very own mason jar light. The next DIY I'll be showing you is a super fun pillow. You will need a pillow, a pillowcase, your cutout stencil design, and of course your paint and brushes. The first thing that you're going to do is tape down your stencil onto your pillow. I didn't show this step, but I suggest doing it so that your stencil doesn't move while you're painting. You're then going to take a sponge paintbrush and brush all around the stencil to create an outline for you to follow. Once you've done that, remove the stencil and take the fine paintbrush and fill in the blank spots. After you let it dry, place a pillow inside, and there you have it, your very own pillow that you have created that all your friends will love. Our last DIY is this super cheap and fun newspaper wallpaper. The first thing that you're going to need is a stack of newspaper, and the second is some tape. You can either use painters or duct. There aren't any first or last steps in this DIY. Basically, what you're going to want to do is place pieces of tape on the back of your newspaper and place them all over your wall. Be sure to be creative with your placings. They don't all have to be in a straight order. Place some smaller pieces on top and have fun with it. Once it's done, you will have a full wall of newspaper that then looks like a wallpaper. I had a lot of fun with this one, and I think it turned out pretty awesome. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did.